But ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you. And ye shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem, and in all Judea, and in Samaria, and unto the uttermost part of the earth. Acts 1:8. These are the last words that our Savior spoke before ascending back to heaven. And in 1973, Bradley and Rhonda Hastings began a lifelong journey endeavoring to fulfill this commission. Their first efforts were to reach out into Jerusalem and all Judea through their home church, the Grace Baptist Tabernacle of Fort Scott, Kansas. It was during this time that the Holy Spirit impressed upon them their need to take the gospel to the uttermost part of the earth. In July 1980, Bradley and Rhonda were approved as missionaries to the South Pacific nation of New Zealand. On October 29, 1982, they arrived in Auckland to begin this part of the Great Commission. God truly blessed their 25 years in New Zealand, where they were able to help establish three new independent Baptist churches, one in Auckland and two in the Wellington area. However, in early 2007, Bradley was teaching through the book of Judges, and as he was teaching concerning Gideon's call, he began to feel the Holy Spirit's direction as to their own ministry. After much prayer and soul searching, Bradley and Rhonda said goodbye to New Zealand and returned to the United States to begin a new ministry. There still remained one part of Acts 1:8 they were yet to fulfill, and they believed that the Holy Spirit was directing them into Samaria. But where was this biblical Samaria? It was first a province within the nation of Israel, south of Galilee and north of Judea. It was a people who were scorned and despised by the Jews. It was an entire culture that had an incorrect understanding about how to properly worship God. Bradley and Rhonda Samaria became the Navajo Nation. This Navajo Nation is a province or territory that is within parts of three southwestern states: Arizona, Utah, and New Mexico, the largest reservation of any American Indian tribe, covering over 17 million acres. It is a nation of over 300,000 Navajos and other mixed tribes, of whom most care little about. It is a nation whose religion is steeped in ancient tribal mysticism, the worship of dead ancestors, superstitions, and ignorance of the true Savior, Jesus Christ. They are a people who need to know the truth, and these people have become the Hastings Samaria. In April 2008, Bradley and Rhonda relocated to the city of Branch, New Mexico, to take up the Native American work that the late missionary Jimmy Winters had begun. There was much to do to regather the flock since Jimmy's passing in 2003, but the Hastings were determined to keep this work alive and growing. Since arriving, they have been involved in evangelizing, teaching, and preaching to these forgotten Americans. The Lord has opened wonderful opportunities as they reach out to Native Americans living in both Cibola and McKinley counties. These counties have large numbers of Navajo and other tribes living in poverty, squalor, and with high unemployment. Alcohol and illegal drug use are taking a heavy toll on these isolated communities. The Navajo presently have the highest youth suicide rate in our nation. So many are desperate and can see no hope of ever changing their situation. But there is hope in Jesus Christ and His salvation. This has been the Hastings message since their arrival. There is hope and salvation in Jesus Christ for all Native Americans. Almost weekly, the Hastings are seeing new contacts in their services. The numbers of those professing Jesus Christ as Savior is increasing, and many have already followed our Lord in scriptural baptism. These same individuals are learning God's Word and enjoy singing hymns and worshiping together each Sunday. These new converts are beginning to see that their family and friends are their responsibility, and their mission field as they work to share the gospel across the reservation. There is more work still to be done. And in order to get all of it done, the Hastings are in need of your assistance. There are several ways that you can help. First, everyone can pray. Pray that God will provide wisdom, that the Holy Spirit will touch hearts, and that Satan and his power will be bound. Secondly, there is need for financial support. The work is great, and so are the costs. However, there is no cost that is too great to see just one soul saved. Thirdly, there is the need for physical assistance. Maybe your church might plan a visit to help in the work, including construction work on the buildings, visitation among the Indians, or maybe even a vacation Bible school. These are all ways that you and your church can become even more involved in winning Samaria to Jesus Christ. The Navajo Nation will never hear if we take the same attitude as the New Testament Jews towards the Samaritans. For the Jews have no dealings with the Samaritans. Bradley and Rhonda are already involved in this needy work. How involved will you become? Remember that Jesus' last words to you were, "Ye shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and unto the uttermost part of the earth."
Like this over 44 years ago that the Lord got a hold of our hearts. I'll be honest with you, I didn't say yes right away. I kept telling God he was calling the wrong person. I did that for a couple months until I could tell God no longer. He said, "I need you. I want you to take the gospel." And it's been a wild ride, folks. God is blessed, and we're excited about what God has done. We're looking forward to what God is going to do. I've got to get through this. This is my first furlough in 15 years. In 38 years, I've had 5 furloughs. So I tell people, you support us, we go to the field and stay. Okay? And so I'm looking forward to getting through this. I will finish up, Lord willing, in June. I have a 3-week trip to New Zealand. Planned the end of June and 1st of July. They've asked me to come back and preach the 15th anniversary of the last church that we started there. And then I get back, and 2 weeks after I get back, or it's basically a week after I get back, I've got vacation Bible school. So that's going to be an exciting summer. It's going to be a very busy summer. And we come at your prayers. We know that you will pray for us. And thank you again for letting us come. It's a privilege to be here. We thank you for that. Thank you for letting us come and be a part of your missions conference. You've been very hospitable. Put us up. You fed us. You're still feeding us. My wife said we share to thank the ladies for the fruit basket. She gives me all these lists of things to thank for. Okay, she never does this. And so anyway, thank you for that. If you have your Bible.